My name is Ilsa Willems. I'm a CVI project coordinator at the CVI Center at Perkins, and this presentation is on visual recognition. Visual recognition is the perception of knowing what an item, animal, or person is because you have seen it before or you've seen something similar to it. When we recognize something, we are comparing something in view to the huge library of objects in our visual memory. So for many of us, we can look at this wide array of ducks and all know that they are ducks, right? We've seen so many ducks in our lives that all the different pictures of the ducks, we can connect that to the familiar ducks that we've seen before. For our students with CVI, making that connection between all of these different types of ducks can be really, really difficult for them. Here's what the research has told us so far about visual recognition for individuals with CVI. Recognition relies on stored information and the ability to retain and recall that information. Individuals with CVI may have difficulty recognizing objects, animals, people, or different facial expressions. Individuals with CVI may recognize based on overall features, for example, the way an animal walks or an object's color, versus really seeing all those details. And they also might recognize an item based on more compensatory strategies, the way it sounds or feels, the way it feels on their lips or in their mouth, versus really visually recognizing that object. How does recognition work? We make connections between what we are seeing and what we have known before. So based on the item's shape and size, based on its function, the context, where it's placed, for example, language being used, and again, all those other senses, that helps us to recognize what's around us. Each time we see that object and interact with it in a meaningful way, our visual reference library can be strengthened. Here on the right, similar to the ducks picture that we saw initially, there's four different types of apple pictures. So clear photographs, more abstract, they're different colors, slightly different shapes or orientation. And again, our reference library is so strong that we can recognize all of those as apples. For individuals with CVI, this might be a bit harder for them. Visual recognition. Individuals with CVI may have difficulty building a robust library of visual memories. Here are some of the reasons why. The object currently in view may be inaccessible, visually inaccessible. So for example, you'll see two photos of soda water, soda cans. One is on its side, and one is, the picture is straight up on top, so you see that tab to open up the can. For individuals with CVI, it might be difficult to see both as soda cans. Maybe they only see the picture, they can only identify it from that angle from on top, because that's where they usually drink it. Or they might recognize it more on its side. One of these pictures might be more visually accessible for individuals with CVI than the other one. Opportunities to view the accessible object may be limited. Maybe they've only been able to experience soda cans once or twice. It can be a lot harder to recognize them. Viewing and interacting may not be linked. So if they've only seen the item before, but they don't themselves drink out of soda cans or haven't seen other people around them drink out of soda cans, they might not recognize it for its function, for what it is. Visual memory may be fragile. Generalization may be limited. And again, other senses may take the lead. So all of these are some reasons why it can be a lot harder for individuals with CVI to have that robust visual recognition. Individuals with CVI may recognize perhaps just a small group of accommodated objects, their own personal, highly preferred, highly familiar objects, for example. Only their own version of an object, but not others. So in this picture, you'll see eight different kinds of cups. And again, our library is strong with cups. Any of those images, you'll know that it's a cup. For individuals with CVI, maybe they recognize just their own cup, that specific color, that specific size, and they might not make the connection between their cup and all these other cups. Perhaps they only recognize an object in a predictable context, so their cup in a kitchen, for example, versus if it's in a different environment. And again, they might recognize based on an object in a familiar or predictable position, similar to that soda picture that we talked about on the last slide. Now we have two examples for students. Here's an example of a student learning to recognize some printed text. So So he's recognizing that text using a very specific set of color combinations. This is what works for this specific student. He really likes that blue on white, that contrast. And again, it's visually simple. It's those black pages on the back. There's increased spacing between the words. So in this picture, a student is pointing to, there's two words on a black piece of paper. One is the next is trucks. And that's it, it's just those two words. And that's again, what's most visually accessible for this specific student to be able to recognize that text. And he's pointing to the word tracks. And there's some nice space in between those two words. Of course, again, there's only those two words on the page. These are very familiar words, very familiar story for him, which again, really helps to build that recognition. And there's supporting field accessibility for this student. It's right in front of him. That's where he sees the best. It's up on a slant board, so it's at eye level. So this is a very customized lesson for this specific student, and that helps him to recognize those words as familiar text. Here's a picture of this same student. This time we're talking about recognizing photos. So the student, again, sitting at his desk. He has a customized social story book that he's holding. So these are all black pages. There's one single photograph per page. So this is customized to him. He's pointing on the page to a highly familiar photograph of himself in a highly familiar, meaningful, and engaging concept. This is a very familiar activity. It looks like in the photograph that he might be getting ready to go on the train or go on the bus, which is a very motivating concept for him. So I'm sure he's really enjoying this social story. Perhaps the student, in order to recognize himself in the photograph, he might be using some color coding strategies. So in the photograph, he's facing away, but he's wearing a bright green jacket. And the student might know, ooh, I have a green jacket, that could be me, versus really focusing on those facial features or other things. Again, in this picture, he's facing away, but the student in general might use more color coding to identify photographs. And just like last slide, this is highly customized to him. So it's against a black piece of paper. There's only one photograph per slide. It's at eye level, really making it as accessible as possible for him to be able to recognize those photographs. And we have two other examples or voices, what people have said, either parents of students with CVI or individuals with CVI themselves. One quote is, "My son said he would like to know why I put ice cream on my sandwich." So this individual, this parent, her name is Kira, was putting some kind of white cheese, maybe mozzarella, maybe feta, something like that, that was all kind of combined together. So the student thought of it as ice cream. The student has more familiarity perhaps with ice cream, so more recognition for ice cream versus another kind of white edible substance such as cheese, that is likely what that was instead. Here's an individual with CVI. He said, "It can get annoying that it takes a while for me to figure out what something is or where something is." We have a whole other slide on response interval, and we've touched briefly also about form accessibility and access to people, and all of those videos will give you a lot more information about what visual recognition is like for individuals with CVI. Here's the current research and literature that we have on visual recognition. Again, hopefully there's a lot more research coming. And lastly, every child with CVI is teachable. Every child has a right to meaningful and accessible education. If you'd like more information about CVI in general, or about visual recognition, check out cvinow.org.